Hi guys, welcome to a new video on Scratch Chemistry. In today's video, we are going to discuss about the Bovelt-Blanc reduction. So what do we mean by Bovelt-Blanc reduction and what is Bovelt-Blanc reduction? So let us start. So write the definition first. What is Bovelt-Blanc reduction? So in definition, you can say it is a type of reduction reaction in which carbonyl compound get reduced to corresponding alcohols in presence of or in treatment with metallic sodium dissolved in ethanol. Okay, so what is the definition? It is a type of reduction. So in short, it is a type of reduction reaction where carbonyl compound get reduced to corresponding alcohol by treatment with metallic sodium dissolved in ethanol. Okay, this is the definition. So now coming to its reaction, what is the reaction? So reaction, okay, carbonyl compound reduced to corresponding alcohols means, if suppose the starting material carbonyl compound is aldehyde, okay, if starting material aldehyde, it will reduce to what? It will reduce to 1 degree alcohol. If the starting material is ketone, okay, if the starting material is ketone, it get reduced to 2 degree alcohol. Okay, reduction R, suppose aldehyde reduced to 1 degree alcohol and ketone reduced to 2 degree alcohol. So in reaction, let us suppose take ketone as starting material. For ketone, we can write it as R dash or R1, R2, you can write it as, and R1, R2 are hydrocarbons. Okay, this is ketone. So to this ketone, if you give 2 moles of sodium, not 1 mole, we are using 2 moles of sodium. Why? I will explain a bit later in the mechanism. 2 moles of sodium in presence of, again, 2 moles of ethanol. Sodium is dissolved in ethanol, 2 moles of ethanol, okay. 2 moles of ethanol C2H5OH, 2 moles of ethanol. It will produce what? 2 degree alcohol, OH, R2H, okay. R1, R2, thus carbonyl compound get reduced to alcohol OH, okay. And floss, what is the remaining part? 2C2H5ONA or sodium ethoxide, you can say C2H5ONA, 2 moles of sodium ethoxide, okay. This is the reaction, and as always, reaction without mechanism is not chemistry. So what is the mechanism then? Let us study the mechanism. This is carbonyl compound, and carbonyl compound, this carbon is electrophilic in nature. So what is the then nucleophile here? This is electrophile carbon. Then nucleophile is sodium metal. Okay, here just mark sodium. The sodium metal, metallic sodium, sodium metal outer orbital electronic configuration is what? Means total electron configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1, and outer orbital electron configuration is 3s1, means in outer orbital sodium have only single electron, 3s1 means single electron in outer orbital. That one electron behave as a nucleophile upon sodium, Na, one electron over sodium. This is nucleophile in nature, okay. So this nucleophile here is will attach to this electrophilic carbon center. Write the mechanism. R2 plus sodium, Okay, sodium one single electron, 1 mole of sodium we are reaching now. So this single electron will attach to this carbon center, and this is half arrow. I am denoting it as half arrow because of single electron. If there is a pair of electron, then it will be full arrow, or it will, if it will be a bond, then it will be full arrow. So one concept is, we can write that this is lone pair of electron, 2 electron lone pair of electron. The lone pair of electron similar, this symbol of similar to one negative charge. Okay, similar I am writing, not same. Okay, one lone pair of electron or non-bonded electron is similar to one negative charge, also similar to one bond. But one bond, okay, so this is similar, not same. So when it attack to this carbon center, this bond moves over to oxygen. Okay, what will happen? So in this, just see the mechanism. The bond moves over to oxygen, then bond is similar to negative charge, O minus here. Okay, then R2. Okay, and sodium gives it one electron to this carbon atom. So there is one single electron near to this carbon atom, this single electron. Okay, and O minus, after sodium donates its electron, it will become sodium plus Na plus. So here Na plus remain as ionic pair to O minus Na plus. So in the next step, what will happen? In the next step, we have ethanol. Okay, ethanol, 1 mole of, suppose ethanol take here, C2H5OH. Okay, ethanol, in the next step, the O minus here takes the hydrogen from ethanol, takes the hydrogen of ethanol, and this bond moves over to oxygen. Okay, C2H5O minus will leave C2H5O minus, and here Na plus. Okay, always charge balance takes place in every step of chemical reaction. So C2H5O minus here and Na plus here combine to form sodium ethoxide ion, and here O minus takes the hydrogen to form alcohol type R-OH and R1 R2 OH. So in the neck, and here is one single electron also. Okay, so in the next step, as this single electron is not stable, okay, so it is very reactive, not stable. So we are using, why we are using 2 moles of sodium? So 1 mole of sodium is used here, so another remaining mole of sodium is used here. Again sodium, sodium have one electron in its outer orbital. So sodium again donates its electron to this single electron. So what will happen? R1, R2, and one electron, and sodium gives another electron. Then there will be two electron. Okay, 2 electron. In the next step, these 2 electron, after giving sodium electron, then sodium become Na plus, positive charge, and the 2 electron is similar to what? One negative charge. So here R dash OH, we can write it as similarly R2, the negative charge here, the lone pair of non-bonded electron, also it can written as negative charge. Okay, so in the next step, what will happen? In the next step, we are using 2 moles of ethanol. 1 mole of ethanol is used in this step, and another mole of ethanol let use in this step. Okay, so here C2H5OH and O minus Na plus remaining, always charge balance. So here the O minus takes the hydrogen. Okay, O minus takes the hydrogen, and this bond moves over to oxygen, similar step. So here what remaining for C2H5, O negative, above O negative, and remaining Na plus charge balance. Okay, O minus takes the this negative charge takes the hydrogen. So what it will form? R1, R2, and here the negative charge takes the hydrogen. So hydrogen get attached to this carbon center, and this is the product of the reaction, what we have written in the reaction step. Okay, so we have got the, this is 2 degree alcohol or not, the carbon atom attached to OH group is attached to 2 of the carbon, R1 R2 are hydrocarbon, 2 of the carbon center, that is why it is 2 degree alcohol. When ketone, this is ketone, okay, when ketone reduced, it gives 2 degree alcohols by using sodium metal, 2 moles of sodium and 2 moles of ethanol. Okay, all of you, I hope you all understood the mechanism. Next, and let's check aldehyde, of reduction of aldehyde to 1 degree alcohol. So this is the structure of aldehyde, COH. This is the structure of aldehyde, 1 hydrogen, this R group is any hydrocarbon. Okay, this is not, if any hydrocarbon, it will not alter aldehyde. Then if you are suppose CH3, okay, this is aldehyde, CH3 COH. To this aldehyde, similarly sodium, 1 single electron, it will attack to carbon center, electrical carbon center, this bond moves over to oxygen, it will form CH3O- H- as single electron, sodium gives, so single electron here, so O- and as sodium gives it electron, then positive charge over sodium. So in the next step, what will happen, C2H5OH ethanol you are using, the O- takes the hydrogen and this bond moves over to oxygen. Okay, so remaining part was C2H5O- and Na+, charge balance, similar step. Okay, so what we got, CH3OH, H, 1 single electron here. So in the next step, another mole of sodium, 2 mole of sodium, another mole of sodium, it donates another electron, sodium donates another electron to this carbon center, then there will be one pair of electron. Okay, and pair of electron is nothing but the negative charge, this pair of negative, you can write it as, similarly negative charge, CH3OH, H, okay, here is negative charge. In the next step again, another mole of ethanol, C2H5OH, and the negative charge takes the hydrogen, and this bond moves over to oxygen, and remaining part, C2H-C2H5O-, here Na+, so remaining part C2H5O- and Na+, okay, and if what it form here, CH3OH, your hydrogen, negative charge takes the hydrogen, so HS, what is the product, see here, CH3OH HH, and this is what, this is 1 degree alcohol. Okay, so that is why aldehyde, when it get reduced, it forms 1 degree alcohol, okay, by treatment with 2 moles of sodium and 2 moles of ethanol. Okay, the question which came in the examination is little difficult, but not too difficult. You can all know the chair form of cyclohexane. Okay, so cyclohexanion structure, this is cyclohexanion structure, 6 member ring cyclohexanion, yes sir, cyclohexane. If carbon group attached to here, then it is called cyclohexanone. Okay, to this cyclohexanone, if you give 2 moles of sodium and 2 moles of ethanol, what will be the product? Okay, what will be the product? Option one, OH here, hydrogen, OH in equatorial position, and hydrogen is in axial position. And option B, OH in just reverse, OH in axial position and H in equatorial position. So between A and B, two options for you, between A and B, which is the right product? Okay, which is the right answer? So the right answer is option A. Why? The right answer is option A. Why? I am discussing the mechanism little bit, so I have to erase these things. Okay, see. So answer is option A. And this product is known as equatorial product, E product you can say. And this product you can say axial product. Why equatorial? And why axial? For axial I am writing A. for equatorial it is E product and this is axial product. Okay, so if you see the structure of cyclohexanol, there are two regions. If you see the structure of cyclohexanol, here is one hydrogen, okay, here is one hydrogen. If suppose OH group is in this is equatorial and this is axial, okay, there are two options. Let us suppose this is option A. Okay, in option A, OH group is in equatorial position. So as OH group is a bulky group and there is a concept in cyclohexane ring, if the bulky group stays or bind to the equatorial position, then there will be less steric hindrance or less steric effect, because the region is, the particular region we called it as a 1,3 diaxial interaction. Okay, here 1,3, how 1,3? This is suppose carbon number 1, this is 2, this is 3. Similar case, this is 1, if this is 2, this is 3. These 1,3, 1,3. Okay, these two hydrogen create 1,3 diaxial interaction to the group which attached to the carbon number 1 here. Okay, so if the bulky group OH group will stay at equatorial position, then there will be no 1,3 diaxial interaction, obviously. Okay, if in option B, what I have written in option B, OH in axial position. So if OH will be in axial position, then you can see there's 1,2,3 and 1,2,3. There are 2,1,3 diaxial interaction. There is steric hindrance or 1,3, 1,3, 1,3. OH to that H is 1,3. OH to this H also 1,3. So there are 2,1,3 diaxial interaction. That is why this product is not stable. So axial product is not stable and it will not form. Equatorial product, as it is stable, it will form. The answer is option A. That is why. So this is the only the concept wise. So what is the mechanism behind it? So you can see, while there is a carbonyl group, okay, and this carbonyl is neither equatorial nor in axial position, okay, it is in between, in axial and equatorial. So in the first step, what of sodium donates its electron to carbonyl and this one moves out oxygen. Okay, so when sodium have only one single electron, and one single electron when it attack axially, okay, it will not create 1,3 diaxial interaction. It will not create. Why? Because the electron is single electron, very smaller in size, it will not create 1,3 diaxial interaction to this hydrogen atoms. Okay, 1,3 hydrogens. So that is why sodium atom, it will attack axially. If sodium atom or sodium electron attack axially, then single electron over here and O minus goes to equatorial position. In the next position, this is according to mechanism, C2H5OH. Okay, C2H5 O minus takes the hydrogen and this one moves up to oxygen, C2H5ONA leaves. So here similar mechanism, what we are getting, OH, and here single electron, again sodium gives another electron to the this, then here negative charge, the pair of electron is similar to negative charge, and here OH remaining equatorial. So that is the product is equatorial. In the next step, C2H5OH and this hydrogen is taken by the negative charge over this carbon, and it forms H at, this is axial, H at axial and OH at equatorial, and this product is the product number A, which is stable. Okay, got it? Okay, hope I explained the reaction well. If you think this video is little helpful to you, you can like the video, you can comment any doubt or any suggestion for me in the comment section. Thank you. See you in the next class.